This week, a controversial vote will take place on a bill which would legalize marijuana in New Hampshire for recreational use. Now, bills like this have been introduced before, only to meet a quick defeat up in Concord. And while supporters hope that renewed attention brought by other states might make a difference, Governor Hassan is nipping this one in the bud.
When it comes to the marijuana debate in New Hampshire, Governor Maggie Hassan is drawing a line in the sand less than 6 months after signing a bill to allow the use of the drug for the seriously ill.
But I don't support the decriminalization of marijuana any further, and I would veto it if it came to my desk.
That declaration comes as the New Hampshire House is set to vote on a bill allowing for the recreational possession of up to an ounce of pot to be sold and taxed at a licensed retailer. This is Colorado and Washington State have become national case studies of states who have taken the plunge.
Marijuana is widely available throughout New Hampshire today, despite the best efforts of law enforcement, and we're suggesting that marijuana should be regulated so that tax-paying businesses who do follow the law are the people who produce it and who make the profits.
Matt Simon of the Marijuana Policy Project points to a recent WMUR Granite State poll released in October that shows 60% in favor of the idea of legal, taxable marijuana sold at licensed stores for recreational use.
I think we need to understand that marijuana has to come from somewhere. If it doesn't come from a regulated market, it comes from an illicit market, and that ultimately helps criminals and cartels.
Members of law enforcement have long opposed the legalization of marijuana in New Hampshire of any kind, and while it would in theory generate millions in tax dollars for the state, Governor Hassan, it appears, will not be on board.
We have some challenges in our state with substance abuse. We need to be focusing on that, and I just think it's the wrong message to send to young people.
And it is also worth noting that it's unlikely that this bill would even make it to the governor's desk anyways. The Senate rejected a similar proposal just last year.